Hello friends, welcome to my channel Tutelf. Today we are going to study about the topic pressure. So pressure is basically the force that is applied on a specific area. Like the pressure that you apply on a specific area is the pressure. Pressure is very much different from a thrust. What is thrust? Thrust is basically the perpendicular force that is applied on an area. But if the direction is not perpendicular, but it's anyways except a perpendicular like this, any case, then that force which is applied on an area is known as pressure. Now there is a specific, there is a trick of remembering the formula for pressure. Let's do that. So what we'll do is we will make this triangle. After making this triangle, I'll write P, F and A. After I have written all the initials, what I'll do is I'll separate them by using a line. So I've drawn this middle line and this the horizontal line and a vertical line, right? Now the horizontal line, it represents my division sign, and the vertical line, it represents my multiplication sign. So this is basically the thing that you have to remember. But you need to draw a triangle and then write P, F, A here and then separate each one. After you have done this, what you'll do is, for example, I need to find the formula for pressure. What I'll do is I'll write pressure, I'll write force and I'll write area. So I want the formula for pressure. So pressure equals, now the line that comes in between the force and area is that of division. So basically I'll put the sign of division here and hence I'll get my formula as pressure equals force divided by area. I hope this is clear to you. Next, let's take what is force. So for force, what I'll do is I'll write F. Then since I want to find force, I'll write equal. And the two remaining terms are P and A. Yes? The line that comes in between these P and A is that of multiplication. Right? So this is a formula we get. Let's check. So force is equal to P times A. Correct? As I have told you earlier as well, the unit of force is Newton, because I've told you that for force, any force, like let it be magnetic force, electromagnetic force, gravitational force, any kind of force, the unit will be Newton, and the standard unit of area is meter square. Now let's see what is pressure basically. So the formula that we will be using most in this chapter is pressure equals force divided by area, and we can easily calculate it. Now what is the unit of force? As we just discovered, it's Newton, and the unit for area, it's meter square. Right? So the unit for the pressure would be Newton per meter square. There is another unit for pressure, and that is Pascal. So Pascal basically gave the unit for pressure, and the unit is PA. Remember students, P here would be capital and A would be small, and this represents Pascal. It is known as Pascal. Fine. So SI unit of pressure is 1 Newton per meter square, which is written like this, Newton per meter square, and other one is Pascal, where P is capital. I hope this part is clear to you. Now let's solve a question related to this. So basically, what is the pressure exerted? So we have to find the pressure which is exerted at the base of this house, and we are given the force, that is 700 Newton. Now how do I know that this is a force? Because the unit is Newton. So Newton means force. Next, I have to find the area. Now I basically know that this is a square. Why a square and not a rectangle? Because the length and the breadth are equal in size, and it has a right angle triangle, right? So the area for a square is area square, or basically to find the area, if I do not want to discover it as a square, I'll do the multiplication of this and this. So I'll get the unit as 4 meter square. Now let's see, the formula that we'll be using here is pressure is equal to force divided by area. My force is 700 Newton and area I've just found out is 4 meter square. So I'll be putting all my values and I'll get my answer as 175. I'll put the units of pressure as Pascal. I could even put it as Newton per meter square. So it is totally up to you. If you want to go for Pascal, go for that. If you want to go for Newton per meter square, go for that. But please do never forget the units, because when you are writing the magnitude, you have to ensure that you write the units. Units are very important. Now let's see. So the formula was pressure equals force upon area. That means that pressure is directly proportional to the force. What does this mean? This is only the case when you know you keep the area as constant. So as a force that you are applying on an object, you keep on increasing the force, the pressure will also increase. So like here, if the person is moving this cart with a much greater force, then the pressure which will be applied on the string as well as on the cart will be more as compared to when you know the force was applied less. Similarly, if the force is kept as constant, then pressure is inversely proportional to area. Now, for example, if I take a pen and, you know, I push it from both the ends, what I'll see is that from the pointed end of the pen, I will get a mark here, but not from the other end. That would be because the area at the pointed tip is very much less as compared to the end part. And so if the area is less, that means the pressure applied would be more. And that is the reason why I get a prick mark here, right? So when you just try this, take your pencil or pen and, you know, try to apply a equivalent force from both the ends. And you will see that you'll get a prick on the finger where the pointed end is and not on the other finger, right? So this means that pressure is inversely proportional to area. Now, how do you basically find, you know, whether the constants are variables are directly proportional or inversely proportional? So the formula says P equals F upon A, right? Now, if I need to find for pressure, so pressure, I have numerator in force and in denominator, I have area. So all the constants, all the variables which I have in the numerator, they're directly proportional to the term mentioned here. And everything that I have in the denominator is inversely proportional to the term I have here. So that is why force is directly proportional to the area and to the pressure, and area is inversely proportional to the pressure. I hope this part is clear to you. Now, based on this, there are various applications, and so let's give reasons to each and every one. Now, cutting edge of a knife is sharp. You must have seen that, you know, the cutter knife is sharper as compared to a butter knife, because we do not intend to cut using a butter knife. But why is it so? It's so because a cutting edge is sharp because that way it will have lesser area. Since we already know that pressure, you know, is inversely proportional to the area, so less the area, more is the force applied, and thus you will be able to easily cut the objects or the vegetables or the fruits that you intend to using the sharp edge of a knife. Next, bags have broader strap. So broader strap would give much greater area, and since pressure is inversely proportional to area, so more area means less pressure. So you will have much less pressure on your shoulders as compared to the bags which have like a very thin strap. So that's why if you would have seen, like, there were a few bags in which they had a very narrow strap, and in those bags you used to have a strap mark here, right? Next is nails have pointed end. So nails are basically used to, you know, hang something up or put something at a place, at a particular place. So you have to ensure that the nail goes in. Nail goes in means the pressure applied should be more. When is the pressure applied more? If one, the force applied is much more, or the area is less, right? So the pointed ends ensure that the area is less. And since, see, you basically, whenever you give reasons, you always have to specify the formula. You always have to specify the relation. Even if you have to specify it like 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, you have to specify the formula. So nails have pointed end because pointed end means smaller area. Since pressure is inversely proportional to the area, that means that greater pressure will be applied, and thus nail will be able to easily, you know, penetrate in the wall or anywhere where you intend. Next, sharp heels are difficult to walk in on smooth grounds. Now, sharp heels have much pointer end, which means a lesser surface area here, which means a more pressure, because pressure is inversely proportional to the area applied. Next, syringe has pointed tip. So syringe is basically the needle that goes in when, you know, you go to the doctor. So since it has to go inside your hand or any body part, so it needs to be pointed. So that, you know, it needs to be pointed, because then in that case, the pressure applied would be more since the area will be less. Now, why is it so? Because we know that area is inversely proportional to pressure, right? Next, porters keep a round piece of cloth on their head. Now, porters, they tend to keep a round piece of cloth, and above that, they keep your luggage. This is because, you know, when they put the piece of cloth, they're increasing the surface area. As the surface area increases, the pressure which will be applied on your head would be less, since area is inversely proportional to pressure. Next, buildings have white foundation. So buildings basically have white foundation at the base. That is because the pressure will be applied more by the, you know, upper part of the building. So that is the reason why a wider foundation will give us wider area. And since pressure is inversely proportional to area, so I will have less pressure being applied on the foundation by the building. I hope all of this is clear to you. So basically, we have done a lot of topics today. Let's summarize them quickly. So pressure is force per unit area. The formula for the same is P equals F divided by A. It is a scalar quantity. Scalar quantity means that it has only magnitude associated with it. It does not have a direction. If it has a direction associated, then it is not pressure. It is thrust that we are talking about. The SI unit of force is Pascal, on the named after the scientist Pascal. Pressure, it depends directly on force and indirectly on area. So you can see that the brick, when it was standing, had applied more force on the sponge as compared to the brick which was lying down, like horizontally. I hope this topic is clear to you. In case you have any doubt, please do write in the comment section. Do not forget to like our video and subscribe to our channel. And also do not forget to press the bell icon. For more educational content related to maths and science, do watch our other videos as well. So till our next topic comes out, stay tuned, stay safe, stay healthy. Take care, bye.